Welcome to our program on Kardec Radio.
Hello, dear friends, and welcome once again to this very special moment, the moment when we hear at Kardec Radio and in all of our platforms unite in prayer. And why now? Because we learn that exactly at 6 p.m. in the higher realms, watched over by the loving presence of Mother Mary, the higher spirits also gather to pray to God and to offer their hearts in service of others. So isn't it lovely, dear friends, that we too, ourselves, are uniting forces with spirits of such loving magnitude? Did you know that you and I and all of us on the earth are co-creators, that we too can help spread love, that we too can serve as the eyes of the Christ, the ears of the Christ, the hands of the Christ, the arms of the Christ, the body of the Christ, as we reach out to one another out of love to spread hope and fraternity to our brothers and sisters near or afar. After all, you and I reincarnated to love, to learn, and to serve. And because this is such a unique reincarnation in which we are so blessed with the fact that we hold the light of discernment and love in our hands, we will read a message by Sister Shayla, the Spirit Shayla, psychographed by the loving hands of Chico Xavier, entitled Blessed Always. So this is our goal tonight, to refresh ourselves spiritually so we see the blessings that surround us regardless of the circumstances. Right, Abby Cher? Good evening to you, dear friends. We hope that we are all ready to count our blessings. And speaking of counting our blessings, dear friends, we will begin this prayerful moment by logging in into the current of the beautiful spirits that sustain us in this reincarnation. And how shall we do so? By speaking to them from the heart. This is why we will begin this daily prayer moment with a prayer. Shall we pray, dear friends? Let us now listen to the sound of silence, because in silence we hear the presence of God, the closest to us in the temple of our hearts. Let us immerse ourselves then in the natural and divine melody of our heartbeats, of our own breathing, reminding ourselves that we have trillions of cells working tirelessly without expecting for recompense on our behalf. It is thanks to them that our physical life is sustained. Let us visualize a blessed divine ray of light entering our physical bodies, illuminating all of our internal organs, thanking all of our cells, blessing the physical vest, cleansing our thoughts, emotions, attitudes, and choices, allowing our utmost recesses of our souls to feel renewed and in contact with the love of the Christ. Being as blessed as we are, we now visualize a basket of this very same rays of light reaching the hands of the Christ, and we ask that he distributes this light to all hearts who may be in despair, all those who may not see his comforting hands, every brother and sister of ours who is experiencing sadness. We pray that where there is sadness, that our Master may bring joy. Where there is illness, that our Master may bring balance. Where there is death, that our Master may bring life everlasting. Where there is hopelessness, may our Master remind each and every one of us that he shall remain by our sides forever and ever. And in the presence of the Christ and in the name of God, we ask for permission to read our message of tonight, through which we shall nourish our souls and spread the good all the more. And so be it. What a blessing, dear friends, to log in onto the current of light brought to us by the Christ, through God, of course, and the beloved mentors who anonymously and beautifully are at the service of the good on the earth, and to boost our very own ability to also be in of service to the good, we will read a message published in the Spiritus magazine, issue 43, by the Spirit Sheila through Chico Xavier, entitled Blessed Always. The Spirit Sheila tells us in the message, wherever you are, bless it, so the blessing of others accompany you. All individuals and all things respond to you according to the touch of your word or of your hands. Bless your home with the light of love in the form of self-denial and work, and your home will bless you with gratitude and joy. Bless the tree of your house with the gift of your affection, and the tree of your house will bless you with the perfume of the flower and with the richness of the fruit. However, if you curse your companions each day with the whip of censor, you will receive the sorrow and mistrust. If you condemn the animal that shares your domestic climate with hunger and flogging, you will get rebellion and harshness. In truth, you cannot bless evil expressed in cruelty, but you must bless the victims so that they may be strong in order to extinguish it. It will not be fair to bless the sickness that afflicts you, but it is indispensable to bless your diseased organ so that it may be more safely readjusted, expelling the disease which sometimes imposes bitterness and imbalance on you. Do not curse even by thought. The aggressive or destructive idea is corrosive in our mouth, shadow in our eyes, hallucination in our arms, and misfortune in our lives. Bless the hands that hurt you, and the hands that hurt you will learn how to avoid delinquency. Bless the word that insults you, and you will avoid the extension of retaliation. Bless the difficulty, and the difficulty will reveal precious lessons to you. Bless the suffering, and the suffering will regenerate you. Bless the stone, and the stone will serve in the building. Do not forget the divine master of blessings. Jesus blessed the manger and made it the luminous cradle of the nascent gospel. He blessed Peter, weakened and faltering, transforming him into a vigorous fisherman of souls. He blessed the obscene Madeline, and therein formed the sign of human sublimation. He blessed Lazarus, dead, and gave him life. And finally, he blessed the cross itself, carving the victory of the imperishable resurrection. Bless the earth wherever you pass, and the earth will bless your passage forever. We feel blessed just by reading the sublime and most beautiful words, right, dear friends? So the spirit of Shayla is a great educator for all of our souls, because she recognizes that the earth is still at this very moment, dear friends, a world of trial and expiations. Thus, she, one, recognizes that there will be suffering. Two, she recognizes that there will be illnesses. Three, she recognizes that there will be cruelty. Four, she recognizes that there will be injustices. Five, she recognizes that there will be imbalances all around us. Yes, dear friends, it is not by chance that our beloved Master Jesus has told us that his kingdom, God's kingdom, is not of this world. Why not? Because there are still elements that are not in alignment with the good at this time. Yes, but of course, we would like suffering to be diminished. Of course, we would like to live in a world free of cruelty. Of course, we would like to shed light onto ignorance. Of course, we would like to solve our difficulties. This is why God has made the law of progress universal, because together we are to co-create a better world. But the question for us tonight, beloved friends, and dear Mark, Carlos, and Daisy, welcome, welcome, dear souls. So the question for us tonight is, how shall we co-create a better world? The world that we dream of, the world that we speak of, how shall we actually co-create it? Sister Shayla, the spirit of Shayla, is giving us the answer. She is telling us, do not, beloved brothers and sisters, run from difficulty. Do not ignore suffering. Do not curse our circumstances. Rather, She tells us that the solution to our difficulties on the earth is in blessing those difficulties. When bless, how many times? She tells us bless always. How is the person who challenges us, dear friends, who is very good at pushing our buttons, going to learn to respond differently if we respond to that person exactly the same way? Perhaps God has placed us in the landscape of that spirit in this reincarnation so that spirit would have a new reference, a new beginning. But if we fail to do our part, then that spirit shall have even more difficulties. So have we thought about the fact that Christ, and of course, above all, God is asking us to bless the challenging peoples on in our lives so that they learn, they feel, they perceive that they too are children of God? Have we thought about the fact that because we hold the light of discernment in our hands and within our hearts, we can transform the meaning of pain? For instance, many of us may be faced with physical illnesses at the moment due to the pandemic. Likely, we know someone who knows someone who is affected, or even by reading the newspaper or going on social media, we come into contact with those of our brothers and sisters who are experiencing great, great, great suffering that goes beyond what one can imagine. What is then our response to that suffering? Are we the ones, alternative A, who say, "Oh, where is God in this situation? If God were here, these brothers and sisters of ours wouldn't be suffering." Alternative A. B, are we the ones who say, "Oh, whatever. It hasn't happened to us directly anyway, so why should we care? We will just go on with our lives, whatever. Things will resolve when they have to resolve." Or C, we say, let us think of those spirits and pray so that they receive a relief from the hands of the Christ. And wow, congratulations to them for being strong enough to undergo this experience. They are examples of patience and courage for us. So we, dear friends, because we have free will, we can choose how we read the events in our lives and the events that we come across on a daily basis. Sheila, who is a spirit already aligned with the Christ consciousness, offers us a beautiful proposal tonight. Essentially, she is inviting us, Abby Cher, Mark Carlos, Daisy, other friends, friends who are watching on demand, and Carol as well, to align ourselves with the Christ too by blessing the circumstances around us. We have a choice. We can curse the circumstances around us. We can disregard the circumstances around us, be apathetic, or we can bless the circumstances around us. We learn with the spirit of André Luiz that there are two mental currents that we as co-creators, as heirs of God, can help construct. One is positive and the other is negative. One is constructive, the other is destructive. Every time we bless, we are adding to the good. So if we are counting on a better world, it is up to us to help mold this better world. If we have a challenging brother or sister in our network, we can choose to read it as a blessing by thinking, well, what virtue might God have in mind for us to develop? Could it be indulgence? Could it be more patience? Could it be forgiveness? Could it be more understanding? Maybe God believes we are ready to develop these new virtues. This is why the challenge has appeared. Not because God doesn't love us, but rather because God believes in our potential to grow further. Do people whom we love discarnated? We can, of course, be upset, miss them very much, continue to love them very much, and be eager to be in their presence. Yes, that's normal for us. But we don't have to curse the fact that God has called upon a loved one. Why not? Because we know that life goes on and that that person's health will be fully reestablished. And that we will re-encounter that person whom we love so much. That person has not, beloved friends, disappeared. So then, if we make this type of effort to do what Shayla is asking us to do tonight, life's challenges become easier for us because we learn to read them as blessings. Is this easy? Not yet, because we are still practicing. But do we have a model to help us that we can look up to? Thankfully, we do. Master Jesus. Yes. So let us visualize Master Jesus alongside with us, as our dear friend Vanessa Anceloni invited us to do in the 11 p.m. program yesterday. When we face a difficulty, when a shadowy feeling or thought lingers around us because of the difficult circumstances we are living in, let us visualize the very Christ comforting us and telling us, "You are a blessing to the world. Please allow your light to shine." So let us repeat this affirmation three times as we march towards our final prayer, determined, beloved friends, to find, actively seek for the blessings in our lives, already knowing that we can count ourselves as one, because after all, we are masterpieces of God. And in the words of Dr. Deirdre Cruz, we are dreams of the Creator that are unfolding. So let us repeat this affirmation to ourselves and then march together to our final prayer. We are a divine blessing, and we shall allow our light to shine. We are a divine blessing, and we shall allow our light to shine. We are a divine blessing, and we shall allow our light to shine as we thank God and Master Jesus for the gift of their love, sustaining us in this precious reincarnation. When we receive love materialized in the form of the promised consoler that is here to bring us hope, to show us that life never ends, to show us that difficult circumstances are blessings from God to us, to show us that in all difficulties we can find signs of God's love, to show us that God never forsakes us. And having received so much, dear God, we pray so that we too can give of ourselves. So at this time, we visualize a beautiful golden rose of healing. And we give this golden rose of healing to someone with whom we are in need of reconciling. We also give a basket of healing flowers for the mentors to distribute to those who are transitioning to the spiritual realm, completing this reincarnation, graduating from school. We ask that the mentors give a basket of healing hearts to frontline workers in both realms so that love prevails in their spirits. We also pray for Mother Mary's loving team, for all the healings they perform, for all the lives they sustain, and we pray for every spirit in the Mary of Nazareth spiritual colony, as we also pray for those battling with addictions and those who feel lonely and forgotten. We pray so that wherever there is a trace of despair or violence, that the voice of the Christ and the embrace of Mother Mary can be felt and hurt and heard in the following words: you are beautiful and unique as a masterpiece of God. Taking in these words of the Christ and feeling Mother Mary's embrace ourselves, we thank God for those moments of prayer and for His unconditional love, as we humbly ask for permission to end this prayerful moments of tonight. And so be it. Thank you, dear friends, for the beautiful gift of you. Thank you for being a blessing in the name of God incarnated on the earth. Let us continue feeling the blessings that are coming from above and pray so that tonight we can be little instruments of through which God can spread all the more love around the earth. May we keep feeling the blessings of God now and always. Thank you, dear Daisy. Big kiss and big hug to you. Thank you, Mark Carlos. Thank you, Abby Cher. A big hug to everyone. Thank you for the beautiful gift of you and many blessings. Bye for now.